Today in this session, we will try to learn about how to create tabs using JavaScript. Example, our output would be in this way. When I click on frontend, server, database. So based upon the tabs click, it should be able to display some message. We will try to do the same thing using JavaScript. So before learning about this, how to solve, we have few basic things like in JavaScript to know. First one would be a style. In JavaScript, if I want to apply a style for an element, in JS, if I want to apply style for an element, for example, see, I have a tag here, hello, paragraph tag close, and in this paragraph, let me apply some style for this. I can write document dot get element by ID. Get element by ID. For this, we can apply style dot color equals to red. Style dot color equals to red. So, but when I'm trying to apply for this, it is trying to read based upon the ID. So, let me name something here, like ABC. ABC. So, here the paragraph element will be red using the ID ABC. And it will be having, it will apply some property called style, that is a color property followed by value red. So if you can see here, we got output as red. First one, in order to apply CSS, in the sense, if I want to apply some styles using JS, then we can write this property like style dot color, or else style dot font size, or else what are the properties if you want to apply, you can just write in between this, choosing a particular element, reading a particular element using the DOM methods, then applying the properties. Next one would be, for example, I have three elements here. For suppose I have three elements, like let me write some example, like div class equals to A. Example, div class equals to A, hello, John. Again, I have other div class equals to B, hello. I have something like this. I have two classes followed by some text in between it. So when I'm trying to traverse this, when I'm trying to check the output of this snippet, you can see hello and John is being displayed. For suppose if I want to choose an element, for example, if it is based on ID, we use document.getElementById. But I don't want to use ID here. I'm trying to use something called a class. We have a method called get elements by class name. Get elements by class name will try to return the list of elements in the document with a specified class name, whatever the name we have mentioned. So if I'm writing document dot, for suppose if I'm writing like this, get elements by class name, only for elements it will be like this, only for ID it will be element, and remaining everything we will be having something called elements. So document dot get elements by class name. So let me read an ID here. What is the ID you want to read? Let me read A here. So for suppose C here, let me write for the both the things, let me write A only. So if I write in this way, if I write in this way, and I just want to echo this in the console, I just want to echo this in the console, like I want to see how many values did it read. As we have discussed, document dot get elements by class name is a collection of class names which it has. For example, see, let me open the output, then we can understand. Yes, if you can see here, we got two divs. In the sense, it will try to have a collection of objects, in the sense collection of the class names, sorry, here collection of the class names. So it will try to read the particular element value, particular class element value. So it has two now, but out of these two elements, I just want to replace the text of second element. I just want to replace the text of second element. Can't we write in the form of array? Yes. X of 0 indicates the first one. Like in the array, 0 indicates first index value, like first value. 1 indicates the second index value, right? So let me write 1 here. And I would like to write inner HTML. Inner HTML, in the sense, it will try to change the based upon the element what we have chosen, it will try to display the text what we write here. For example, I want to write here as Hello, Johnny. So if you can see based upon the, we can write the same thing using button also. Like we can take a button, we can perform some function, and then we can also execute the code. See, first suppose I want to write a function name here as hello. This is the function name here, hello. I just don't want to execute the code as the page loads. If you can see, we have hello and all these things, and I just want to take a button here. Button on click equals to, I'm trying to take an event here, and I just want to call this function hello click me. So once I click on this click me button, automatically these two properties has been applied. In the sense, these two, the style and the get elements by class names is been applied. First property is style would make sure that it will try to apply some colors, and class name will try to read all the elements with a particular class name here. Our class name is A, so it has read two elements. Out of this, I'm trying to apply only for the first element. In the sense, array of the first element, it has a collection of, like, in the form of array. So I have read the first element and I'm trying to change the text. So hello has been replaced by hello Johnny here. So this is how we have done with a simple example required for solving this question. And one more thing is left, like apart from get element by id, style and class names, we have some something more called current target. What is this current target? So if you can understand this, current target is an event property. Like it will try to return the element where the event has been applied. For example, I'm trying to apply the event for the body. Let me write a basic example, like we can understand like what we are trying to do now. So here hello is there. Let me write here itself. On click equals to. See, for example, when I have clicked on a particular thing, then it will try to display that element. So on click equal to my function. Let me write hello itself double slightly. Let me write my function. So let me write my function here. In this, I'm just trying to pass an event. So what is event here? We can say event is an object. Event is an object. It has the information of what action we are trying to apply. Event is an object that contains the information about what action we have just applied. For example, here I have taken the function name as my function and event. Suppose let me write another function here. First, suppose I'm trying to write another function here. My function. In this my function, let me pass an event. In this alert event dot current. So current target dot node name. So I just want to get a pop-up box. If a user clicks on a particular element, it should be able to display that particular choice. See here. Let me refresh this. We got body. So we can use this. We will be using this property of current target in event bubbling. There we can use. For example, we have nested events, and I just want to pop up the particular div. Then we can go for this current target. So it will try to have the event listener based upon the event. Like it is used in capturing, bubbling and all these things. Now let's come to the question. Like we should be able to solve something called, when I click on this, it should be able to display some text. So let us try this thing now. So let me put everything in the comments. I'm just trying to put everything in the comments here. Now comes the real logic. See, let's see how it goes. Yes. Let me write the first one. Here if you can see the first part, we have something called the technologies. We have something called the technologies. So let me take some text here. H2 technologies. Just I want to get some heading part here. Technologies. For this H2, I just want to write CSS part here. Text align center. Nothing more. So if you can see here, we got technologies. Let me apply some Google fonts for this. Let me apply Google fonts also. Let me take this one. So let me take this property. Hope it's look good. Let me take another property. So I'm trying to use this. I'm just trying to use this property. Select this style. I just want to use the CSS. Where we need to link? We need to link in the CSS part. That is the head part. Next one, I just want to use this font family, right? So for the complete body, I want to take the similar font. I just don't want to change another font. Let me write body. I have included a Google fonts here and I have written the font family name. So let me refresh this. If you can see, we got technologies. So we got the technologies here. We got technologies. First part is done. Next one, I need a bar like this. I just need a long bar. So let me write div class equals to bar. Let me write div class equals to bar and let me close this. In this, I have written something called bar. For this bar, let me apply some properties. As it is a class, dot followed by overflow hidden. Let me write border. Let me take one normal pixel. See, I'm trying to use the colors because I'm just trying to take all the colors. Next, a background color. See, I already have done this, so I got to know this hexadecimal property. You can apply any of the colors which you are like. So I got this. Next, I got a bar here. I just got a bar. Now in this bar, I just got a line. I just want this bar in this format. So in this bar, what I want to put is that I just want to place three buttons. So let me write button class equals to bar links. I just want to use an event here, onClick equals to. In this, I just want to write a function like showTick JS code. I want to write event followed by UI. So based upon the event, it will try to call it. So here I'm trying to pass this in the format of a string. So I got it. Next, let me close this and let me write here as front end. I'm just trying to write three different buttons here. First one, let me check this. I got front end. Now for the same button, I want to take three buttons. So here, first one is UI. Next one, I want to name it as a server. Next one, I want to name it as a backend. Just a basic example, front end. Next one, I just want to write here as server. And the next button, I want to name it as backend. So we got three buttons here. If you can see, we got three buttons. Let me apply basic CSS for this. So what is the class name we have taken? Barlinks. Okay, barlinks we have taken. So let me take bar. Inside this bar, I have a button. We have a button in this. Border none. Padding 14 pixel, 16 pixel. And I just want to have, see, if I'm trying to apply this property, you can see the difference here. I got in this way. I got three buttons, right? Now in this, I just want to have some transition also, like in order to, next one, when the user hovers on it, font size, let me take some 15 pixel. Okay, 14 is also fine. Let me write color white for this text. And the background color, I want to have the same color code how we have taken for this 346 260. So now if you can see this, in this bar, we are trying to take for this bar links. So it means we are trying to apply for the button. So I have taken bar and button. So we have applied for these properties. If you can see, we got three buttons as it is. But now here, if you can see, we have three buttons here. In these three buttons, I just want to write some property, like when the user hovers on it. Let me write button hover. Let me write some brown color or else, which would find with this color combination. So let me write. So let me write here as 497. So I got this thing, like when the user hovers on it, I'm trying to say, we can call it as a pseudo class where we are trying to apply for the links also, we will do the same. Next one, I have something called a bar. Everything is done, like we have all these three things, but when I click on this, I should be able to display some information on this. So for this, I'm trying to take a bar content, So for this, let me have, for example, if the button is active, in the sense when the user has clicked, when it is active, I just want to change the color also. I just want the color to background color. Let me write the same color code. But here also it is the same, right? So let me write here as any other color code, CFD and ACE. Yes, done. So we got three. So here it is brown and here it is somewhat like grayish color. Now we got for hover also. Now I need some information like this. So when its user clicks on it, I need some information. So for each and everything, I should be able to take some info. So if you are aware of how to put IDs, buttons, then it is very easy to understand. So let me write, for example, in order to navigate within the same page, we in the hyperlink, we give some IDs. So in the same way, we are trying to write div ID equals to, what is the ID name we have here? First one is UI. So let me write the same thing. And here, class equals to bar content. If you can see here, I just want to name this thing in the form of H3 tag, HTML, CSS, JS, all the skills, whatever you have or so on. And let me close this div. If you can see here, we got this one. Let me write another thing. For which next element, what is the element we have? Server, right? Control V and I have a server here. So let me write server here. And next one is backend. So here I'm trying to create an ID where I'm trying to link everything. So here let me write the skills as Java, PHP, Python, Node. Here let me write SQL. I just want to use SQL and there are so many. Okay. So we have these three things. But our agenda is when the user clicks on it should be able to display, and the remaining should not be visible. In CSS also, we have some property called display none. In the sense, when we don't want to show something, then we can write property of display none. So for this bar content, let me put some CSS. This would be the last CSS for this, where I want to put some line for the content. So bar content. So for this bar content, let me put some properties. I just want to write it as display none first thing. So see here, it is not visible. Now in this, I just want to apply padding, in the sense from top and bottom and left and right, only two sides. Next one is border, where 1 pixel solid has CCC. Next one, border top. I just don't want to border on the top hand side. So let's see now. So we don't understand the output, but when I remove this, so can you see we got a border? I haven't applied border here, so let me write control that we got in this one. but once I click on this, it should be able to display the particular version. In the sense, when I click on UI, it should be able to display. When I click on server, it should be able to display, and backend, it should be able to display. So for this, let me write some code. What is the function we have taken here? We have taken some function showTek. Okay, so let me write showTek. showTek is a function name which has two parameters. Two arguments here. One, the first one is an event, and next one is a the value which we want to pass. So let me write event. Event and course. I have taken two things. First one is event and course. Once the user clicks on this button, this function should be able to work. This function should be able to work. So first, let me read bar content. First, let me read this bar content. So how we can read the classes? We can read the classes in the form of document.getElementsByClassName, right? So here I would write, bar content. First one, bar content equals to document.getElementsByClassName. So when I've written getElementsByClassName, what is the class name we have? Same, bar content. So here it will have three values, 0, 1, 2. In the sense, in the form of an array, it will try to have three properties, line number 17, 20, and 23. Now, I just want to iterate this thing. In the sense, I don't want to display these values. I equal to 0. Let me take var I here. So that I don't want to declare it again and again. I less than bar content dot length. It means it will try to iterate this for 0, 1, and 2 based upon the array values. How many we have? 0, 1, and 2. We have 2. 0, 1, and 2. The length would be 3, but we have till 2. In this bar content, let me write bar content dot style dot display equals to none. It means it will not display anything, but using CSS also we have done the same. But here the logic is we should be able to display something called this one. This when the user clicks on this bar links, we should be able to have some property. It should be able to apply some property. So let me write again, let me declare here bar links also. So bar links equals to document dot get elements. Is it by get elements by class name? Yes, because we have written class here, bar links. So we got bar links here. Now in this bar links, let me take where I equals to 0, I less than bar links links dot length I plus plus. Bar links. So here I would like to apply a property where it would able to have a class. In the sense, when I'm trying to use this bar content and active, so when I want to apply these properties, so here in this, here it is the main logic where we will try to write. I'm trying to write bar links of let me pass I dot class name. In the sense, for the bar links of 0 would be of class name. So what would be like, it will have the first class name, next one 2, next one 3. It would be equals to bar links of I dot class name. We are accessing the class name and we are trying to replace this with active. So hope you got this line, what we are trying to do. So we are just trying to iterate the line number 12 to 15. So we are trying to access this and we are trying to replace the properties of active. In the sense, for example, if I have written active for this, so only this would be highlighted, right? For example, if I have written active for this, it means only first one will be highlighted, like in the navbar, like how we have done. Now, based upon the active, it will try to have. See here, next one, document dot get element by id. Get element by id. Why we have taken id here? Because I want to display a course. I just want to display a course here. So if we can see here, we have these three things. Like we have done with these three things. So this course will be based upon this value, like UI, server, and backend. So here it will pass the UI or what is this? Server or backend. This is the course here. In this style dot display, style dot display equals to block. It means based upon the class which is active, it will apply this property. Which property? Display block. Now in this event dot current target dot class name, class name equals to active. So the element which is active, now it will try to display. See here, we have some issue in this. Let me check console. So showTech is not defined. Let me write showTech. So we have written showTech here. We have written showTech, right? The same function we are trying to write it here. Okay, now it is not saved, sorry. Now next thing, we have one more issue. Line number 32, where is it? Okay, nothing more, like I just need to paste comma here. Like it is in the for loop, so we got it. Again, we have an issue. Let me click on insert. Sorry, it is already there. You can just check the in this browser console part. None is not defined. Line number 35. The reference none is not defined. Sorry. Whenever you use CSS, you should be able to include this thing in the inverted quotes, like how we have done. Line number 35, it is not defined. Let me take bar content dot style dot display, right? Okay, so here if you can see, cannot set the property because we are trying to read all the elements, but we haven't passed the index value here. So once we pass the index value, based upon it, it will be none. Yes, so if you can see this, we got front end, server, and backend. In this, the main logic here is front end, server, and backend. We have taken the three buttons where in the form of a tab, like we can tell this as a tabs, like JavaScript tabs. Here we are trying to use a long bar like this, and in this we have placed three buttons. We were trying to call a function where it will pass some event and followed by the corresponding course value. It will try to match based upon this ID. For example, if I don't write U here, see UI is there. Once I click on this, it will not perform. Rest two will be working fine. Based upon this ID, it is trying to match. How we do in HTML, like navigating within the same page, we use some ID in the hyperlink. Now in this, we have called a function where we were trying to read all the three values of this bar content, and we have assigned it to none. Next one, based upon the link, it is trying to replace with an active. Which one it is active, it will try to display that. So based on it, it will try to display the particular course element. It will be displayed. So this is how we have done with how to display tabs using JavaScript. So this is a basic example, like we have done using JS. Like if you are aware of how to read DOM elements, class element, get elements by class name, event current target, how to apply CSS, and how to read a values using a for loop, then you can easily understand like how we have done this. In the description part, you will find the complete series of JavaScript. If you have any queries in this, you can just comment below this video. Thank you.